Guacamole is one of my favorite dips to make, and it's kind of surprising that something that can taste so good can also be healthy for you. So I'd like to show you my recipe for guacamole. Here are the ingredients if you would like to jot them down or do a screenshot. They'll also be below the video if you would like to print them out. So when I make guacamole, I like to start with my avocados first before I prep any of my other ingredients. And this is because I can't always get really fresh avocados at my grocery store. For some reason, sometimes they feel perfect on the outside. You know, they're not too hard and they're not too soft. They just give just a little bit, and then I'll get them home and there'll be some bruising in there. There might be some brown spots. Then it just kind of ruins my guacamole. So I like to get in there and look at the avocados first to make sure they look good. And then I'll go in and get the flesh. So fortunately, these look pretty good. They're a little bit smaller than what I usually get, but I'm using two to make this dip. So I'll go ahead and get the flesh out. And now to keep the avocado nice and bright green, I want to go ahead and put my lime juice right here on the avocados. And I'm using the juice of one lime. This was a nice juicy lime. Sometimes they're not so juicy, so you might want to have an extra one on hand in case you need a little more juice. And we'll just give it a little bit of salt and go ahead and mash it up good and make sure the lime juice gets well incorporated into the avocado. Okay, and now for a little bit of flavor, we're going to grate in one clove of garlic. And I want to grate in my red onion. So now I want to go ahead and prep my peppers. I have two jalapenos here and two serranos. I'm not sure that I'll use all of these right now. But what I want to do is just kind of scrape out the seeds with the tip of the knife. I like to try to leave the membrane intact because that's where the heat is. And I like the heat, but I'm not real crazy about having the seed in there. So, but you can leave the seeds. You don't have to take this step. You can just, you know, chop them all up if you want. I am going to only put one jalapeno in here and then two serranos to start with. That might be more than you need. I certainly recommend that you add as much heat or as little heat as you want. Okay, I am going to put a green serrano. I also decided at the last minute to put a red serrano. So I just want to mince these. I want them to be very, very, very finely chopped. Sometimes those seeds can be hot because the membrane holds the seeds, of course. So that's where the seeds get their heat. And we'll go ahead and mix this in pretty good. And now I want to chop my cilantro. So the cilantro is beautiful here in the fall. So I don't want to use the very end here, the stalks, because they tend to get a little bit tough in something like this. So I'll discard those. And now I'll taste for heat and see if I need any more. And it was perfect. But I do want to add one more thing. And that is some black olives. I love black olives in my guacamole. When I ate guacamole for the first time, it had black olives in it. And I've never had it that way again, so I always have to add them myself when I make it at home. But that is certainly optional. And now I'll taste for salt and just see if it needs any more, because you know those olives will add a little bit of salt. Maybe that's why I like it so much with the guacamole, because it gives a little bit of saltiness to it. Anyway, I hope you're able to give it a try. If you enjoyed the video, please let me know by heading down there and giving me a big thumbs up. And then if you haven't already, feel free to hit that subscribe button. If you click the wheel off to the right, you'll receive all notifications from my channel. So thanks so much for watching, and y'all have a beautiful day.